Welcome back to Let's Play Baldur's Gate Enhanced Edition Blind. I'm Emmett the Solitary. Wow. Losing my voice. And we're downstairs in the basement of what looks to be the Iron Throne headquarters. No, it's not the Lannisters or King's Landing. We came in through the sewers here. And here is stairs up. So, I was supposed to infiltrate this place. The guard didn't even believe us, so it doesn't look like a subterfuge is going to be the way. But maybe. We'll see. We had to kill the guard. He's, well, there.
Sure.
Awesome. We got merchants. I love these old cinematics. I mean, I've only seen the first few of the Enhanced Edition cinematics, and they're nowhere near as good, so I can only imagine that all of them are nowhere near as good. Now the funny thing is, you'd be like, well, aren't you playing the Enhanced Edition? Just in case just any of you are not aware, I have a mod installed for the classic movies, which restores the classic movies. So you can play the Enhanced Edition and see the old movies. And that is the best way. And that goes outside or to another room?
Why me?
All my stuff is authentic. Really, it is.
What is your business here? If you hear about obtaining iron shipments for your company, then you'd best to do so elsewhere. We have no interest in dealing with other companies.
All my stuff is authentic.
Hey, no time to chit-chat.
Uh-oh. Here comes a guard and a triador. Welcome to the Iron Throne Citadel. Could you please state what business brings you here? I could try to bribe him. We've business with your leaders. We just come from Sembia and are quite weary. We're seeking employment. I'm here to kill all those who would associate themselves. Well, we can afford to step it up as far as gold. If I were to give you these 200 gold, would you not ask any questions and just let us in? We don't have any questions. Come on in. Triador says, out! Away! Fly while you can! There be madness here, and I can stand it no longer. Calm down and explain yourself, good sir, that I may understand you better. Calm down? Calm down, my Saravak's acolytes practice their magic cacophony above me? I dare say not, stranger. I dare say not at all. Triador appears busy. All right. Madness above. Okay. And that goes above, I see. Oh, then what goes out here? Let's go above. So this is the main floor.
I should have joined the army.
Who are you? Dratan? Where do you think you're going? The fifth floor. Saravak asked us to deliver an important message to his acolytes. Humph. Better you than me. Working with that crowd can be downright creepy some days. Creepy? How do you mean? I've seen people go up there with one face and come back down with another. I don't know how else to say it. I got a keen eye for faces, I do. And I think them people going up and down know it too. 'Cause one time one of them caught me looking at him and he winked right at me and he changed the color of his left eye. Right as I was watching him, it started out a chocolate brown, but then it went all quicksilver for a moment, like the mercury the mages play with, and then he was gone and out the door, laughing his high-pitched laugh. I think we should have kept that sort of, shapeshifter, it was like plus two to shapeshifters or something. Oh well, we sold it. That is creepy, Imowen says. I definitely don't want to have anyone copy me. I'm the only one allowed to be Imowen, after all. Don't worry, I won't let that happen. Thanks. You better not attack the wrong one, though. Got it? Don't worry, I know the real one from a shapeshifter copy any day. I hope. Thanks. That makes me feel a little better. I'll do the same for you, okay? Oh. Who are these people? I was asking her. Competition of the Iron Throne. Mostly members of the Seven Suns Trading Coster of the Merchants League. They have both been attempting to negotiate a tentative peace between the different economic powers in the city. I fear it's not peace they're finding, however. At least not of the type they came looking for. Something's going on upstairs, and I'd rather not think about what it could be. Journal. That's not the journal, it's this. Something is rotten in the Iron Throne Tower, and something that is cancerous and malignant and growing. Dratan, one of the tower guards, has informed me of something most dire. It seems that the throne has been inviting their competitors in the Seven Suns and the Merchants League to the tower's fifth floor and in doing something horrible to them. Are they being turned into zombies of a sort? Are they being poisoned with a powerful drug? Are they being replaced somehow? I don't know. Regardless, the implications are staggering and, to be honest, terrifying. I must steel myself and continue my ascent, however, for I know not what else to do.
Why me?
And he's gone. Okay. So he's so afraid of what's going on upstairs, yet he runs upstairs. Nothing to look at, no goodies. No door out here. Okay. So then this would be the...
Good on you if you save the day.
Third floor, thank you.
All right.
What is this? No... Nortuary? Is that like mortuary, but... It's with one different letter. Wait a moment. Could you please tell me where I could find Realtar? It's important that I speak to him. I've been given a runaround too long. Realtar's damn son, Saravak, seems to think he's in charge here. Haven't we heard of a Realtar? I've heard of Saravak. I must ask for a name. We must ask for a name before we go telling the whereabouts of Iron Throne High Ups. I'm Nortuary, and your Iron Throne High Up answers to me. I've just arrived from Selgaunt in Sembia. The Council wishes to know how things are faring. Now tell me where I can find Realtar. I don't know if this is true. Probably lying, but that's okay. Realtar's in the upper offices at the moment. If you go up there, I'm sure you'll catch him. Good. Finally, I got a straight answer. He's gone. Okay.
I've got the best prices this side of Cormyr.
What are the likes of you doing in the dining chambers? Dismiss yourselves immediately before I have you thrown out. Speaking of which, here's a guard. You there! What are you doing here? I don't recognize you. 100 gold. Sambia. New recruits. Didn't work before. How about you just take this 100 gold and look the other way? We're looking the other way. Now get out of here.
Don't give me any lip, peasant. Do you know who I am?
Beg your pardon. At last, someone who looks like they could be of assistance. The assorted boobs and dimwits around here have been of very little help. Don't talk about your boobs like that. I'm Dimwit. This is my good friend Boob. And behind me you find Brainless and Moron. Of course. How may I assist you, ma'am? Really tempting, though. Ma'am this, ma'am that, I have little desire to suffer through more of your flat gentility. You may call me Emissary Tar, and direct me towards the nearest staircase. I have some important business to conduct on the 5th floor on behalf of the Grand Dukes. Okay. You're an idiot. There's a staircase right behind us. Emissary Tara, would it be untoward of me as to inquire as to the nature of your business on the 5th floor? It is hardly a secret. The Grand Dukes have sent me to negotiate a new iron treaty with Thaldorn. It appears that the Merchants League and the Seven Sons have voluntarily granted the Iron Throne temporary control over their mines in order to simplify the city's supply structure and thereby strengthen the war effort, should it come to that. I am here to ensure that we have access to that iron at a favorable price. The Iron Throne has been more than cooperative with us to date, and I doubt they will change their tune now. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have no intention of being late for my negotiations. But we didn't tell you where the staircase was. How did you all of a sudden realize? My chance meeting with the Grand Duke's chief negotiator, Emissary Tar, has provided with new clues. The Merchants League and the Seven Sons have temporarily relinquished their minds to the Iron Throne in support of the coming war effort. They may find the temporary loan becomes all too permanent. Ma'am, don't go up there. I should have warned you. I thought I could have... I was just trying to stall you and get information and then warn you. Well, you're a snooty type, so I don't mind that much. What do we have here? A cook. And a cook.
Hello?
You there. This is my kitchen, and I don't like interlopers, so get out. How rude.
Hey, friend.
I must apologize for me fella here, John. He gets real irate, real easy. You'd do best to avoid him when he's in these kind of moods. Oh, please, I'm not worried about John the cook. Okay, up to, I'm guessing this is the 4th floor? Another merchant.
Why me?
Merchant. And bartender.
All my stuff is authentic. Really, it is.
Ah, look, some newcomers. I assumed that the lot of you had just arrived with new supplies from Ordulin. If you're looking for Realtor or Brunos, look no further. Both of them have traveled to Candlekeep on important business.
All my stuff is authentic. Really, it is.
Same thing.
What you want?
Destus Gurn says, hello. You must be the city negotiators. Let me see on the list here. Emissary Tar? Right on time, and a pleasure to meet you. My name is Destus Gern, Assistant Chief Accountant for the Iron Throne's operations on the Sword Coast. Now, just a quick briefing on our negotiating procedures before you head on up the stairs. Thaldorn will be accompanied by a board of six from Throne advisors sent to us from abroad. Zalamor Cloudwolf, Gordish, Naman, Diab... Diab sounds familiar. Esim and Alai, all of them quite respectable men and eager to meet you. We also have a seventh member on that board today, a Mr. Lyle Espejo. He is there to ensure that all things go smoothly in this time of transition. As for the agenda... Okay, so Tara came up here. Where did Tara go if you did not meet Tara? Yes? On the agenda, as you well know, are a discussion of our current offer regarding iron prices and some notes regarding the output of the new mines we have acquired. Preceding all of that, however, Mr. Espejo would like to have a few words with you about the positive change and dynamism, economic and otherwise, that he has been witness to in his recent travels through the Sword Coast region. I do not doubt that you will find it interesting, but I have taken enough of your time. Please proceed upstairs so that the negotiations may begin. Imorne rubs her head. I'm getting a headache listening to this guy. I thought we left all those boring lectures at Candlekeep. Eh? Alright, it seems the Iron Throne is negotiating a treaty with the city's Grand Dukes. Is this simple treaty the key to ending all the unrest of the past season, or is it just another link in the long chain of motivations? I think it's the latter. Will money satisfy the throne's greed, or is there something more behind it all? I have so many questions. While I feel close to finding answers, I somehow doubt they will be quite as fulfilling as I hope. Alright, let's go back here. Books. Books. Who's got room? You got some room. Oh yeah, I have some stuff I haven't transferred over. Yeah. I have to identify this at some other time. Take that. Still carrying around this body. It's a frozen spider egg. Alright, yeah. Books.
I don't want to talk.
All right.
History of Shadowdale 12. I think it's 10 and 11 that we need. 10 and 11, yeah, and North 10. And we need History of Estegund. Was the one we saw in Entar Silvershield's estate. We got Cormyr instead, which I didn't realize I didn't read. Shadowdale 10. 10 and 11, right? Just checking. Sweet! We got all the Shadowdale books. I believe there's 12 of them total. I got some reading to do now. 4, 3, Chosen of Mistra. I have those. There's 13 then. Do it. Did I pick up a 13? Let me see. Yeah, I picked up 13 in the manor house in Nashkel. Tethir. I found Tethir, right? Definitely sounds familiar. Yes. I found Tethir in the manor house as well. Bell in the Depths. Ooh! Old person, stinking cloud, and flame arrow. Chosen a Mistra. Dales in the Elven Court. And the North 5. I need the North 10, I think. Instead we got no alignment, protection scroll, and shield. Awesome! Shadowdale! We are Shadowdale soon. So we got no alignment. Flame arrow. Stinking cloud. I just wonder if she knows all of them. Yeah. Write the magic for flame arrow. Okay, let's save. Because I don't play around with that. I'm pretty sure she knows Stinking Cloud, yeah. And those two will sell off. Old person, shield, protection scroll, just hold on to that. Awesome. Goodies! Still need that one History of the North book, though.
Sure.
Hi.
I love money. Yes, I do.
So, what can I help you with? Tell us everything you know. We'll kill you where you stand. We were sent here with the understanding that you did all the hiring for the Iron Throne. I apologize. Someone has made a mistake. We are hiring no one at the moment. I hope there hasn't been too much of an inconvenience, but could you please leave now? Do you mind? I'm a very busy man, and I don't need these...
Decency is refreshing. So many we meet are...
I love money. Lacking. Yes, I do.
Thank you for your kind words.
Okay, I don't need these constant interruptions. We're interrupting him complaining about constant interruptions.
Sure.
Oh, we can go through that way. All right. And you're going to go through that way? Okay.
I love money. Yes, I do.
So what can I help you with? We're looking for the leaders of the Iron Throne. And why would you be looking for them? Might I ask you who you are and what you're doing here? From Sembia. From Cormyr. We're merchants in from Sembia. We have important news for your leader. Well, Realtar is in here right now. I suggest you find an inn and wait for his return from Candlekeep. The hell is he doing in Candlekeep?
I love money. Yes, I do.
Go pester someone. All right.
I love money. Yes, I do.
So I hear. Did we talk to the bartender?
You want some whiskey?
Hey there, mate. Don't recognize you, which is strange, considering I know everyone here at the Iron Throne. Why don't you tell me who you are? Merchants out of Sembia seems to work. Sembia, huh? Well, if you're looking for Realtar Brunos, you won't find them here. They're off to Candlekeep for some important business. What could they be whining at Candlekeep? Well, let's proceed upstairs. Zalamar Cloudwolf says, "Fear my wrath, for it is great indeed. Who dares intrude upon our negotiations?" Is that Tar? I don't know if that's Tara or somebody else. My name is Emissary Tara. I am here to negotiate an iron treaty with Thaldorn on behalf of the Grand Dukes. How many Emissary Taras do we have now? Three? Fool, Miss Tara stands right before you, and she was just leaving. Weren't you, my dear? Honestly, it's gone on long enough. All right. I was kind of fooled by what happened on the floor below, or the two floors below this one. Where they, Yeah, the other guy was completely fooled into thinking I was Emissary Tara, but she could only have come up this way. I've crushed all those before you. Certainly a little coin would ease your conviction a bit. A little gold to make you turn the other way. You have breached an inner circle, fool. There are no hired lackeys for you to bribe here. No mercenaries that slither at the sound of coins. We are servants of Saravak, and Saravak alone, selected by hand to protect his destiny. You are an insect. You will be crushed. His will be done. So Saravak is your god? Is that a depiction of him? Well, he's obviously the big man in charge here. In any case, we have Gardouche, Ally, you know, the ones we heard about, Zalamor, Cloudwolf, oh, a doppelganger, and Naaman. Where did, what's her name go? Oh, wait, that was her. That was Tara, was actually a doppelganger.
What?
Not sure if it would work, just in case. Sleep spell. Magic missile.
My blade will cut you down the side.
We knocked out the doppelganger, apparently. Ally cast Shadow Door. Wow. I haven't seen that yet. Zalamor is barely injured. But barely injured is better than uninjured. Da-na-na-na. Oh, crap. This is not good. Sapphire is confused, as is Minsk and Imelin. Who is that? Gardouche. Oh god. Branwyn's dead. Still confused. Oh wait, I don't want her to take it. No. she not? Okay. I can't select him. I don't see anything wrong with him now. So we've still got Asim, Diab, Zalamar, badly injured. Okay, now I can see that he is panicked. Not much to do. Minsk is down. Zalamar is near death. What does she have available here? I was hoping she could free someone from being held or panicked or something, but no. Near death. Well, if we can kill him, that would be good. Yeah, I don't think we're gonna make it. Okay, he's dead. Anyone else free? No. She might be... Yeah, everyone's pretty much cleared out of here. Hopefully we don't kill everybody. Oh, I hit... Did I hit him? Yeah, belay that order. Can't heal anybody, I can't do anything. Still confused, still held. The only one free is Dinah here, it's crazy. Gardouche is badly injured. She's gone. I'm back? I am back. What's going on with me? Oh god, now I'm stunned! I can't do anything. Wow, pretty brutal. Okay, I'm gonna call an episode here. Stay tuned for next episode when I hopefully do not die again. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time, and always seek adventure.